Without the use of high-affinity, highly specific antibodies to various epitopes, especially on a large chromatin remodeling machine, it's very challenging for us to actually pursue mechanistic discovery. The goal of the work is to really understand the structure and the function of this large class of chromatin remodeling machines. And we know particularly for the class we study, mammalian switch-knife complexes, there are actually three subcomplexes within that family, which we've termed canonical BAF, PBAF, and non-canonical BAF. And our goal is to understand how these complexes work independently and together, and most importantly, to try to unveil new therapeutic opportunities for the very large group of human tumors and other disease settings that have mutations in the individual components of these regulators. So I started my young laboratory at Dana-Farber and Harvard Medical School in 2014. And as we were starting to get going on studying a number of different components within this large regulatory complex, we realized there was really a paucity in effective reagents for studying this. And I think, you know, prior to the surge of sequencing studies, the interest in this complex was there, but not nearly as much as we see now. You know, now with the sequencing studies really pointing to substantial roles and driving roles in human cancer, I think this has really stimulated major interest by the field worldwide. And so it's really now that that has catalyzed the interest and the need to develop new reagents for the study of these complexes. And so as I started the lab, you know, we realized that we would have to develop new reagents, and I was very fortunate to come in contact with cell signaling technology. And together, we've worked on a number of different targets within this class of chromatin remodeling complexes to really drive forward the development of effective antibodies. One exciting project that our lab and cell signaling technology have been able to spearhead together was really the development of an antibody that is specific for the fusion version of a protein that's actually a component of this BAF complex. So this actually goes back to my earliest work with the identification of a protein called SS18, which is actually a subunit, a member of this chromatin remodeling complex. And we care particularly about that protein subunit because in 100% of cases of a rare but highly aggressive sarcoma subtype called synovial sarcoma, 100% of those patients have a chromosomal translocation that results in a fusion oncoprotein. And that fusion oncoprotein is essentially the fusion between this SS18 protein on BAF complexes and another protein called SSX. Now, historically, that's been challenging to study because there are really no antibodies for this little fusion piece called SSX. And cell signaling technology has actually developed a wonderful antibody now for SS18. But to try to identify an antibody that was specific for the fusion remained a long-standing challenge and major sort of barrier to progress and even for diagnostic purposes in the field of sarcoma research. And so together, we worked to actually develop an antibody that is specific just for the fusion breakpoint. And I think this is exciting not only for our efforts in understanding the chromatin biology of this SS18-SSX fusion, you know, on chromatin, where it maps on the genome, where it drags BAF complexes too, but also in clinical specimens for the identification of and diagnosis, actually, of human synovial sarcoma. And so I think this antibody is a very exciting product of one of the collaborations we've had together that will impact not only the basic science research, but also the translational and even clinical research applications.